I think that has to do with what we do. And what we do, as the court stated, that the rescue captives bred wolves and humans is like telling us in pets. These are animals that are killed in the exotic pet markets. And our model is that wild animals are not pets. We need to give those rescues a permanent lifetime facility. We use our center as an education facility, and some of our animals are all free as educational tools. So animals that can be safely left there, we know we have four that I can come out and find out of the 52 rescues we have there. And we just feel like when we talk about our story in the public, we're using conversations with people and people don't know what is this. And we feel just like when we talk about the fact that wild animals shouldn't be like that. And also there's just an opportunity to make sure the different kinds of folks that we wait for years and different kinds of things to do about that, like why we're going to get them.
This is when we first found out, and this is in the reading.
Yeah, Lorena was my education partner at Arena in 1997, I think it was. Yeah, February of 1997. And of course, he scared me off, I mean. And I always say, you know, he didn't live on an island, and he tended to listen to me. We became fast friends, and we traveled the United States and mostly Southwest as an ambassador here, teaching people about wolves, getting the British school system, squad groups, TV interviews, radio interviews, all we could to teach people about wolves. The goal of that is a lot of the best of Fortunately, before Logan passed away, Billy was born, and Billy lived right next door to each other. And I bumped him one day. I saw Logan in the room and talking to Logan on the floor, and I went to the room, and I was tired by going out in public. And it's not about good, you know, you can go out of that big habitat and go meet the public. So I really think that somehow there was some of the things being commissioned because Billy, at 4 years old, had a higher sulfur level than Logan at 4 years old, and definitely has a lower fuel threshold because he is by nature a neophobic, and they are very afraid of new environments, new places. This is, I think, to be very scary for you. But he's a great guy, and he's chosen to a lot over the last 30 years. But he's actually still working to really see his pleasures today. His pleasure is he talks to the public that we're having, but we're able to spread them out at this
point.
Well, that is funny, yeah, and I like this. But he did, you know, and that's what's happening in our whole research group, as you can see.
But when you go out in the program, you can complete a lot of the people who came to go to schools and
local farms. Yeah, we're very involved. And it's important for you to pass that message around. But one thing really is that this is not the big barrier between a lot of people who are children. But this is also not a pet. This is a wild animal. And I remind people that we only have two types of animals in Canada. We have wild animals and domestic animals. And this can make a mistake with the wolves. And this is a wild animal. He doesn't want to be in our house. He doesn't want to be our pet. And if you're living wild and free, you shouldn't be having tigers and lions and bears and things like this in our house. Yeah, I have a family policy. My family at home, and my wife and I have a tiger. We're not going to have anyone at home who can eat us. Yeah, so we think that's a good thing, healthy, this is not going to be evil. This is not a cow. It's not a cucumber. And I ended up traveling 500 miles in a week's time in July, but provides all that space, all that time. I mean, my story was dramatic. I said, wrong, think, you're walking up in your backyard, and think it's going to be content. So yeah, I really had to take the business on a short work pass. But at the same time, when you have the opportunity to see on the surface as full, you use them as an ambassador for the species and going to clubs, groups, schools, churches, wherever it can come to that work. Yeah, this is a very specific role in nature. And the removing from nature would be allowing nature to fight back. Or a two-sign species. And whenever we remove a two-sign species from nature, all the powers are going to fall apart. And the great example that we have in America in nature today is the Earth from Africa. When the words are removed from the Earth, we saw so much happening as the browsers became, as the grades became browsers after those grades that won the players. And we began the deer, the elk, the moose began to destroy the aspen groves, and the aspen groves died, and flooding erosion happened, and it was just this long, falling down system of nature. So, we definitely want this in nature. We want the two-stone species to remain in the wild. It allowed the coyote population to actually explode and increase by 30% across our country. And now we have coyotes in places we never had them before because of the wolf epidemic. Wolves and coyotes are very different ways in nature. The wolf role is that they are a primary hunter and secondary scavenger. The coyote's role is a primary scavenger and secondary hunter. So the coyotes actually eat the leftovers that the wolf
babies. Yeah.
think there's one thing that a neighbor or the animal control deems inappropriate, who's at the spirit of the animal, or is in the animal. So, you know, we can never recommend that people ride on animal control. Even though it looks like a dog, it's not going to be a
people who are getting qualified at age 2 to 3.
Because about between age 2 and 3, they're suddenly pursuing and then they're pursuing something that's probably between 3 and 4 years old, and then they're ready to go, because then they're not pursuing something that's for you to be ready to have them be much earlier. So they're in the first fall, so it's getting easier after adding that, you know, there's really a difficult reason, and then suddenly at age 2 or 4, they're asking the big school is stepping in the way of fitting that space for lunch. If I were in a wild, I'd be having a thing called ritual domination, but I'd be just fixing him. He's faster, he's stronger, he's smarter, he's nicer, he's more dominant, he's more assertive, he's more aggressive, he's more aggressive. They don't get that in the family. So when they're kind of wake up and answer big questions, they start way off down and take their lunch. They need to dominate the small child in his family to find out if I fit there. And at first, they want to do the dominant that we do, which seems to be in charge of the house. Or that guy who comes home from work every day at 5 o'clock or comes home to see where he's going to leadership. You don't want that happening. And we have an enemy here at 1,500 pounds per square foot. And even in the first inhibited by it can be very dangerous for small
thousand persons.
And because currently, if you do rescue dogs from here, it costs us approximately $7 per animal per day just to feed these animals. You can't take them out. So we're sending away 1 to 7 animals each and every week on average. So we have a few phone calls that are being used. I need to help our 100-year-old workers. 100. I mean, people are having to get back to our stations for a while before or We have to focus more of our attention on rescuing and educating people about wolves. Every day, we're very sincere. We've got 52 groups of wolves in our country, one of the five of the world's dogs in the world, the indigenous human dogs. Our sanctuary is all around the large habitats, no one's in cages. The small habitat we have for a pair of wolves is 5,000 square feet. So, really want to focus on people on the website and doing more animals in bad situations and bad situations, and finding even other places around the country that are trying to get a good thing for you, helping them out with
that.
Thank you.